Hi, this is Justin the Poodle Guy, and from now we're going to embed a Wordwall widget on Moodle in two ways. One is by using the embed code that the Wordwall website gives us, and the second way is by using either a Poodll widget or a generico filter widget, which will make the embedding easier and also make the embedded Wordwall responsive, so it changes size according to the device and the screen size that the student is using. Right, well, here we are on our Wordwall page, and this is the Wordwall activity we are going to use today. We'll first embed the activity. So we go to the embed link, which can be accessed from just beneath the player itself, or we can click on the share link, the share button. There's also an embed area there. And here is our embed code. If we just copy that, then it's copied to our clipboard. We can go to our Moodle course. Now I've set up two pages, one for embedding and one for using widgets. So since we've copied the HTML embed code, we're going to use the embedding page. Okay, then we go to the settings for the activity because we're going to add this to the page content area. And if we were to paste that code now, it will just look like code, which doesn't really help the students. So let's not do that. Let's use the code editor, which is the very last of the icons on the HTML toolbar. You'll need to click the little expand toolbars icon to see that. And it's right here. Once you've clicked that, you're seeing the code for the HTML in this particular content area. Paste in the code. And when we toggle or untoggle this code editor, we'll see the Wordwall activity. Again, there it is. Save and display. Okay, and there's our Wordwall activity. Now, one of the drawbacks of embedding in this way is that this size of the Wordwall activity is fixed. It won't become smaller than this and it won't become larger than this. So as an example, let's have a look at what would happen if we show this in the size of a mobile phone. Okay, so you can see it's looking a bit squashed there. If we undo that, it comes out like this. So squash it up again, it starts to look like this. So it doesn't fit very well onto the page. And of course, as we have a larger page, we might want to get more of an experience like this one here, where it takes up more of the screen and the student can see more. So in order to address that shortcoming, we can use the widgets to put the Wordwall activity onto the page. So if we go to the page that we've prepared, and again, we access these settings. Okay, and this time, instead of using the code editor, we're not going to use it. We're going to use the widgets icon. So this is available if you have Poodll filter installed, or if you have the generico filter installed, or if you have a Poodll net site in which it's already set up for you. So if you click on the widgets icon, then you'll get a list of the widgets that we can use, and one of those is Wordwall. And if you paste in the URL to the Wordwall activity here, then we can embed in a different way. Paste in our Wordwall URL, insert. And this time we don't see the activity in the preview, but we will see that when we save and display. So that looks much nicer, doesn't it? That fills the entire view area of the width of the view area. And that'll run nicely inside our site there. Now, let's have a look and see what that looks like on different sized screens. So let me reduce that to the size of a mobile phone. And that looks pretty good inside the mobile phone view. If I bring that back out to the size of a normal browser where we just were, it's restored again. So it's adjusting to the size of the page. So that's a far better way of embedding the Wordwall activity. So again, to to use the widgets, you'll need to have the Poodll filter installed or the Generico filter, or if you have a Poodll net site, it's already there for you. The Generico filter is free, so if you want to go and get that from the Moodle plugins directory, that's available for you there. The Poodll filter and the Generico filter are third-party plugins, so if you want to use those on your Moodle site, you'll need to install them. They are available from the plugins directory on moodle.org, and the Generico filter is free. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more videos like this. If you want to learn more about Poodll for Moodle or Poodll Net, visit us at poodll.com.